Let's start with the next chapter. Next chapter, that is Nelson Mandela, A Long Walk to Freedom. A Long Walk to Freedom. Nelson Mandela, he was the president of South Africa. South Africa was president. And in South Africa also, there was a white domination for centuries. कई सदियों तक मतलब वाइट डोमिनेशन था. ब्लैक पीपल देवर नॉट अलाउड टू इवन देवर नॉट अलाउड द बेसिक फ्रीडम्स. जो उनकी बेसिक फ्रीडम होती है, मिनिमम फ्रीडम होती है, दैट वाज नॉट अलाउड इवन दैट वाज. एंड ही स्ट्रगल्ड अ लॉट. दे ही स्ट्रगल्ड फॉर द फ्रीडम ऑफ ब्लैक कम्युनिटी बिकॉज ही बिलोंग टू ब्लैक कम्युनिटी. एंड फाइनली इन 1994 in South Africa, non-racial democratic government was established. Non-racial, not based on any community and all. एक community पे based पे नहीं. Means every citizen participated in the elections and all. Government was formed by the majority of the people. Those who won the votes and all. Those who vote more votes, majority of people they won. And that is the lesson about that. It is a part of an autobiography by Nelson Mandela. It was a part, usme se part tha, and he explained what was his ambition. Uska ambition kya tha and what did he face during that as a freedom. There will be two, three, first in detail, that brief part, I'll start this chapter. Okay, then if time permits, we will go for now this. Okay. The inauguration day actually starts with the inauguration when he took as a president of South Africa. This is South Africa ke president bane and oath taking ceremony jo shapath grahan samarah hota hai in that one. The 10th May dawned, 10th May, it was 1994, 10th May. And it was a bright and clear, bahut hi bright, matlab sun was bright, there was no cloud, weather was very fine. And many world leaders had been coming to the author to pay the respect to him. Means many dignitaries and the world leaders, they came to South Africa to respect the people of South Africa for their establishment of non-racial democratic government in the country. Because up to this time, there was a white domination in the country. Jo gore log the, unka matlab government chalti thi, and even the black people, they were deprived of the minimum basic freedom. जो उनकी कम से कम जो बेसिक फ्रीडम थी वो भी उनको नहीं मिली. इट वॉज बिफोर द इनोग्रेशन. द इनोग्रेशन वॉज टू बी इन द लार्जेस्ट गैदरिंग ऑफ द वर्ल्ड लीडर्स. मीन्स ऑन द ऑन दिस अफ्रीकन सॉयल, अफ्रीका की सॉयल पर सबसे ज्यादा गैदरिंग जो फर्स्ट टाइम इट वॉज देयर. ये पहली बार. द प्लेस कहाँ था उसका? एक्चुअली इट वॉज इन ए यूनियन बिल्डिंग. द इनोग्रेशन सेरेमनी टू प्लेस इन द बिग ओपनिंग बिल्डिंग in Pretoria, one open building it was there. And here the South Africa's first democratic non-racial government was to be installed. Means the after oath taking ceremony, they will take over the governance of the country. This country ka governance to uski sarkar chalane ka to responsibility. Now swearing in ceremony means oath taking ceremony, swearing oath taking. On the day that author was in the company of his daughter Jenani, उसके साथ में जो Nelson Mandela के साथ में थे, डॉक्टर डॉक्टर उसकी जेनानी एंड डॉक्टर डी क्लार्क था, वॉज द फर्स्ट sworn as a second डिप्टी प्रेजिडेंट. सेकेंड डिप्टी इट मीन देर वर टू डिप्टी और वाइस प्रेजिडेंट होते. ही वॉज सेकेंड एंड देन Thabo Mbeki was sworn as the first डिप्टी. एक फर्स्ट डिप्टी था एंड अनदर वन वाज द सेकंड डिप्टी प्रेसिडेंट. इट वाज द ऑथर टर्न द ऑथर मींस एक्चुअली ये जो था नीति जे ऑटो पार्ट ऑफ ऑटोबायोग्राफी, ये उसकी ऑटोबायोग्राफी का पार्ट है एंड दैट्स व्हाई ऑथर इट इज ऑथर टर्न. एंड ही वाज स्वॉर्न एज ए प्रेसिडेंट. जब वो प्रेसिडेंट की उसने शपथ ली, ही प्लेज टू ओबे एंड अपहोल्ड द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. उसने प्लेज लिया कि ही विल अपहोल्ड द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन अबव ऑल. सबसे ऊपर वो कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन को रखेगा. And he also pledged to devote himself to the well-being of the people. लोगों की भलाई के लिए, लोगों के काम के लिए अपने आप को devote करेगा, उनको उनके प्रति अपने निष्ठा. The author address. Now he spoke. Now what he wanted to do, what experience he was having. ये the author spoke of the newborn liberty for the black community. Black community के लिए जो newborn liberty थी, उनकी freedom थी, उसके लिए उसने बोला. ही थैंक्ड ऑल द इंटरनेशनल गेस्ट लीडर्स एंड डिग्निटरीज. जितने भी बड़े बड़े लीडर्स थे, ऑल डिग्निटरीज, ऑफिशियल्स थे, एंड ही थैंक्ड देम फॉर being with the people of South Africa at this auspicious occasion. इस तरह के शुभ अवसर साथ देने के लिए he thanked the dignitaries and the world leaders. He said that they had come there to be with the countrymen and it was the common victory for justice, peace and human dignity. Means what was the, they struggled a lot for near about decades. कई डेकेड्स तक उन्होंने स्ट्रगल किया था. इवन नेल्सन मंडेला ही रिमेन्ड इन जेल फॉर नियर अबाउट 26 इयर्स एंड बिकॉज इट वाज ए विक्ट्री ऑफ जस्टिस, न्याय की, पीस, शांति एंड ह्यूमन डिग्निटी, मींस एक मानव का एक अपना निष्ठा होती, सम्मान होता. ही प्लेज टू लिबरेट हिज पीपल फ्रॉम द पावर एंड ही टू कोट दैट ही विल लिबरेट द पीपल फ्रॉम पॉवर्टी, सफरिंग एंड किसी भी तरह की सफरिंग एंड डिस्क्रिमिनेशन, कोई डिस्क्रिमिनेशन, भेदभाव नहीं होगा. मतलब पॉवर्टी को रिमूव करने की कोशिश करेंगे एंड कोई भी जेंडर दया नहीं. एंड द डिस्प्ले द जेट्स, नाउ हाउ द सेरेमनी टू प्लेस, जैसे उसके बाद क्या होता, व्हाट वाज द प्रोग्राम देयर. आफ्टर ए फ्यू मोमेंट्स कलरफुल साउथ अफ्रीकन जेट्स एंड हेलीकॉप्टर फ्लू ओवर यूनियन बिल्डिंग, उसके ऊपर फ्लू ओवर यूनियन बिकॉज ही वॉज द प्रेसिडेंट एंड दे वॉन्टेड टू एक्सप्रेस देयर लॉयलिटी, उसकी अपनी वफादारी को दिखा रहे थे. एंड इट वॉज फॉर द मिलिट्री लॉयलिटी, मिलिट्री की एक लॉयलिटी थी बिकॉज बींग ए प्रेजिडेंट, प्रेजिडेंट इज द सुप्रीम कमांडर ऑफ डिफेंस फोर्सेज नॉर्मली एंड दे शो देयर लॉयलिटी टू द डेमोक्रेसी ऑफ ए न्यू गवर्नमेंट, जो नई गवर्नमेंट थी उसको. देन द हाइएस्ट मिलिट्री जनरल हैव मेडल्स ऑन देयर चेस्ट, जो उसके ऊपर मेडल थे जितने भी, एंड ही सैल्यूटेड द ऑथर, उसने ऑथर को सैल्यूट किया. एक्चुअली हियर ऑल्सो नेल्सन मंडेला ही फेल्ट दैट अ फ्यू इयर्स अगो ही माइट हैव कॉट हिम एंड अरेस्टेड हिम एंड पुट हिम टू द जेल, कि कुछ दिन पहले शायद अगर मैं इनको मिलता तो ये मुझे जेल में डाल देते. बट नाउ ही सैल्यूटेड एंड ही थॉट दैट दे वुड हैव अरेस्टेड हिम मेनी इयर्स बिफोर, काफी साल पहले तो उन्होंने अरेस्ट कर लिया था. Now singing of national anthem. Actually earlier there was only one national anthem for the white people. White domination was there and there was no national anthem for the black people at all because they were deprived of all the basic freedoms. And the day was symbolized for the author by playing two national anthems. On that day, two national anthems were sung. There may be a question in the in your exam, this type of question. Why there were two national anthems? Because now, black people, they also gained the freedom and they are considered equal now before the law. And that's why the two national anthem, one was for the white, another one was for the black community. And the white sing Nikosi Sikil and the black sing Dai Stan. That is the name of that song. Uska song ka naam hai. Those inform the old anthem of the country. The author thought, now what he started thinking over this, means he was a president, what he started recollecting about the future because he was a president. It was not that simply he has become a president. There are many people who sacrificed. And now what he's telling about that, let's see. On that day of inauguration, the author thought of the history, that they have traveled, they have gone through. And in the first decade of the South Africa, people had passed up their differences with other black-skinned people. South Africa people had passed up. In the first decade of South Africa, ये पहली बार है कि उन्होंने they have patched up का मतलब they are coming near to that, near अब एक दूसरे के नजदीक आना, that black skinned people and they had built a system of superiority also. उन्होंने थोड़े से patch up करके and they have built up a system of superiority. वही अपने आप को superior समझ लेते हैं and they were only controlling them. And it was the basis of the harshest society, मतलब society के लिए it is very harshest, बहुत ही दुख वो था society के लिए. This system had now stood overturned, अब ये overturned हो गया था. Overturned means uprooted, remove करके new system was established, नया system था. Now it was the system that recognized the rights and freedom of all the people of South Africa, irrespective of their caste, color or creed. उनकी caste, color और creed को देखते हुए किसी भी विदाउट एनी बेसिस, कोई बेसिस नहीं था. ओनली थिंग दे वर द सिटीजन ऑफ साउथ अफ्रीका, कि वो साउथ. नाउ द ऑथर रिग्रेट, ही फील सॉरी फॉर, बट द ऑस्पिशियस केम आफ्टर सैक्रिफाइस ऑफ थाउजेंड्स ऑफ पीपल, हजारों लोगों की कुर्बानियों के बाद दैट डे हैज कम, इट मींस दे गेन्ड फ्रीडम फॉर द ब्लैक कम्युनिटी. ब्लैक कम्युनिटी के लिए उन्होंने फ्रीडम दी. एंड नाउ ही हिमसेल्फ सेज, उसने कहा एज ए प्रेसिडेंट आई एम द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ साउथ अफ्रीका बट आई एम नॉट अलोन, आई एम द सम ऑफ ऑल दोज पैट्रियट्स, वो जो देशभक्त हु हैव गॉन बिफोर मी, जो मेरे से पहले चले गए हैं, और हु हैड मेड सुप्रीम सेक्रीफाइस फॉर दिस ब्लैक कम्युनिटी, इस ब्लैक कम्युनिटी के लिए जिन्होंने अपनी मतलब सबसे बड़ी कुर्बानी, अपनी जिंदगी की कुर्बानी दे दी है, आई एम द सम ऑफ दोज, मैं उनका योग हूँ, मीन्स अलोन आई एम जस्ट नथिंग, मैं अकेला कुछ भी नहीं हूँ, विदाउट देयर सेक्रीफाइसेस आई इट वुड हैव नॉट बीन पॉसिबल, बिना उनके सेक्रीफाइस के शायद ये पॉसिबल नहीं होता, मतलब ही स्टार्टेड थिंकिंग, इस तरह से सोच रहा था, एंड he was pained that they could not thank, I could not thank, he was also very sorry that he could not thank them, unko thank nahi kar paya wo, because they have gone out, they have sacrificed their lives for the sake of the community. Now the freedom fighter remembers, now he started remembering all those, now the policy of apartheid created a lasting wound in the country, lasting, long lasting, kaafi din tak जो भरने वाला घाव नहीं था, it was very lasting, and his people, जो उनके लोगों को दिया गया, what was that policy of apartheid, apartheid का मतलब क्या था, discrimination, रंग भेद की जो policy, that was that gave a very lasting wound to the people of his country, उसके देश के लोगों को एक काफी गहरा घाव दिया है, and this policy has produced it because of that policy, because of that discrimination policy, and the produced a great fighters like Oliver Tambo's, these are the name of the freedom fighters, ye unke naam hai, Walter Sisler's and Chief Lutlis Yusuf Dadus etc, matlab is tarah ke log tabhi paida hue hain because of if we go through our freedom struggle, agar hum apne freedom struggle ke bare mein agar baat kare, because of the discrimination, because of the exploitation, because of the exploitation and all done against the Indians. That's why the people like Bhagat Singh and all, they were produced. Because it is because of the exploitation and discrimination behavior of the British and all. Okay. Now, the definition of courage. According to courage, what is, these are the questions that it will be asked. According to what does Mandela mean by courage? Courage ka matlab kya tha? The from those people, the author learned that the meaning of the courage, because of the courage, what is the meaning of courage? He learned from the people, he learned from those patriots who have sacrificed their life, jinhone apni zindagi ko sacrifice kiya hai, unse wo seekh rahe hain that they risked their lives, they underwent great torture, because great tortures were given to them, and he learned that the courage was not a absence of fear, means if you are not having any fear, that you can't be called a courageous person, it's not a courage. It is win over the fear, victory over the fear, that is called courage, that is courage. Now he tells something about the human quality, a human quality ki baat karta hai, chahe koi kitna bhi matlab cruel ho, kitna bhi unkind ho, but still everyone is having the instinct of human quality, aur isi human quality ki jhalak zarur hoti hai. The author says that no one is born hating another. क्योंकि नो वन इज बोर्न हेटिंग अनदर, इफ यू ऑब्जर्व द स्मॉल चाइल्ड, छोटे बच्चे को अगर आप ऑब्जर्व करो, व्हाटएवर यू शो ही विल रिएक्ट अकॉर्डिंगली, ही और शी विल रिएक्ट, उसी की तरह रिएक्ट है, लविंग एंड हेटिंग वी टीच, एक्चुअली लव इज नेचुरल, लव तो नेचुरल है, बिकॉज ही शोज द लव एंड अफेक्शन, दोज आर ट्राइंग टू टॉक टू हिम और हर, उससे जो बात करने की कोशिश करते हैं वो दिखाते हैं, बट हेटिंग एंड ऑल वी हैव टू टीच, हमें टीच करना है, एंड दैट्स व्हाट मंडेला टेल्स. Once we can teach someone to hate, it means we can very well teach, we can easily teach love, to love someone. किसी को प्यार करना हम उनको और अच्छे से सिखा दें, because love is a in this instinct is natural in human being. ये एक natural है human. And they could taught me love, taught him to love. The author says that no one is born hating another person. किसी को hate करते हुए कोई पैदा नहीं होता. Everyone is born with the love. And due to the color or religion, chahe kisi ka koi color hai ya koi religion hai, hating and all it cannot. And they could be taught to love. Love comes naturally to human heart. Means it is a naturally, it is already there only. Usko thoda sa tap karna. In the prison, they were pushed to wall because many tortures and whatever it was given in the cells, jo unki jail mein diye gaye the. बट साए ह्यूमैनिटी इन हार्ट्स ऑफ द गॉड्स, लेकिन उसने ह्यूमैनिटी कहीं कहीं दिखाई दी थी स्टिल इन द गॉड्स और इन द पुलिस, एंड इट वॉज मेन इसेंशियल गुडनेस, उनका इसेंशियल गुडनेस था, ये उनकी अच्छाई थी। इट कॉन्ट बी पुट ऑफ मीन्स फॉर सम टाइम इट कैन नॉट, इट कैन बी हिडन, इट कैन बी हिडन बट इट कैन नॉट बी एक्सटिंग्विश्ड, उसको बुझाया नहीं जा सकता। दैट इंस्टिंक्ट क्वालिटी ऑफ लव, इसको बुझाया नहीं जा सकता। नाउ व्हाट इज मैन ड्यूटी इन लाइफ, एवरीवन नाउ ही स्टार्ट एक्सप्लेनिंग व्हाट आर द ड्यूटीज दैट मैन पर्सन हैज टू परफॉर्म इन द लाइफ, मींस एज ए फादर, एज ए सिटीजन एंड ऑल, व्हाट आर द इन लाइफ एवरी मैन हैज ट्विन ऑब्लिगेशंस, ट्विन ड्यूटीज, ट्विन ऑब्लिगेशन, व्हाट आर द ट्विन ऑब्लिगेशंस टू हिज फैमिली, टू हिज वन ऑब्लिगेशन इज टुवर्ड्स द फैमिली मेंबर, in the family member, wife, children, father, mother, and another duty is towards the community, complete community or the country, pure country ke prati usko kya farz hai as a citizen, and what is the responsibility or obligations towards the community. The author find it difficult to fulfill these two obligations, especially in South Africa, in that atmosphere, जो पहले वाला atmosphere था, in that atmosphere it was very difficult to produce the fulfill the both obligations, dono obligations fulfill karna, it was very difficult, काफी difficult था, and it was because of the colored man in South Africa was punished if they lived like a human being, because if they live colored means he is black people, if they live like a human being they were punished, wo punished there. Such man was forced to live apart of his own people, means they are separated from the community, unko community se separate kar diya gaya, if they try to fulfill the responsibility towards the community, apni community ki taraf agar unhone apni zimmedari karne ki koshish ki, it means they are separated from them and they are put aside, unko alag kar, so there he was not allowed to do the duties to his family also, to his family also. The freedom defined, now he defined freedom as a student, as a child, or as a adult. As a student, क्या आप फ्रीडम चाहते हैं? As a child, what is the meaning of freedom? Means as a student, suppose you come to school and all, what type of freedom you want? You want that there should not be class, no teacher should come and all these things. This is all natural, but after all, this cannot be a freedom because according to you, and that's why the freedom changes according to the age. Of age के हिसाब से ये change होती है. The author was born free because he was born free. No one is born free, and it was but he was not born with the hunger to be. He was not born because he was born free, and he was free as long as he obeyed his father and obeyed the custom and tradition of tribes. जो अपने उसकी tribes थी, community की, जो भी करता, he was free. But soon he realized that his freedom was an illusion. Illusion means it's not reality, not in reality. It was just a fake, unreal. And he began to hunger for freedom when it was taken from him. When his freedom is removed from his, when he was deprived of his basic freedom. He started longing for that, uski ichha karne laga, and as a student he wanted freedom to be. Now as a freedom, this question is very important, what does he mean by freedom as a student? As a freedom, he wanted freedom to read and go wherever you want to see. Whatever you want to read, please, whatever you want. And as a young man in Johannesburg, he wanted freedom to be as for his potential. Means there are three freedoms. See, freedom as a boy. Freedom as a boy, he explained that as a boy, he wanted to go roam in the village, gaon mein, and swimming in the clear stream of water. Clear water of stream. So stream thi, wahan par jo nadi beh rahi thi uske gaon mein, in that he is having a freedom to swim. And that was the freedom as a boy. But as a student, wanted to read, stay outside. Wanted to read, stay outside. But as a adult, what was freedom to him? What does he mean by freedom to him as a adult? As a adult, to have the family and able to earn according to the potential. उसके potential के हिसाब से वो earn करने. Now desire for freedom made him bold because he was deprived of the freedom and that made him bold. इससे वो बहुत ही bold हो गया था. Bold means actually courageous, साहस. But soon he saw that he was also not free like other his brother and sister. Brother and sister means the people of his community, uski community ke logon ke taraf. And then he joined the African National Congress. And the National Congress political party which was struggling for the freedom of the people of that country. Un logon ke freedom ke liye jo struggle kar rahi thi, he joined that political party. His hunger for freedom became a great for the freedom of his people. उसकी जो हंगर थी for the, it became a great for his people. उसके लोगों के लिए उनकी फ्रीडम एक बहुत बड़ी बात हो गई. And the desire for freedom for his people to live with the dignity gave him a power. जैसे to live with the dignity, एक आत्म सम्मान के साथ जीने की जो चाहत थी. And that gave him a power. Because of that he became very bold. वो बहुत ही बोल्ड हो गया था. And it made him bold. It made him live like a monk, because when he tried to take freedom and all, when he tried struggled for the freedom, he just acted as he was made to be a monk. Ek bhikshu ki tarah. He was not allowed to stay with the family, apne parivar ke saath. And the chain on him, his people became the chain. Means the chain on him. What is that? Because all the community, this black community, they are deprived of the freedom, basic freedom. Iska matlab unke upar jo chain hai, wo खुद के ऊपर भी एक है. Now oppressor and oppressed. Oppressor means those who are oppressor who exploits. जो exploit करता है, जो शोषण करता है. Oppressed means who is exploited. जो exploited किया जाता है, जिसको और शोषण किया जाता है. Luther knew that the oppressor must be liberated like oppressed. दोनों, both are actually they are not free. ये दोनों ही free नहीं है, according to Nelson Mandela जो. A man who takes away another man's freedom, जो दूसरों की freedom लेता है, he is and becomes the hater. मतलब he becomes the victim of a hater. वो नफरत का एक शिकार होता है. And no one is free if he is taking someone's freedom. इसका मतलब he is not free if he is taking someone. Both oppressor and oppressed are to be robbed of humanity. उनकी जो मानवता है, उससे वो both are robbed of. उन दोनों को rob कर लिया जाता. Okay, this was all about your brief description or introduction part of this chapter. Introduction part of this chapter. Okay, anything you want to ask still, you can ask. Yes, students. Yes. Okay, students, let's start the chapter. Nelson Mandela, A Long Walk to Freedom. Introduction part is already over and let's start reading the chapter. 10th में डांट ब्राइट एंड क्लियर. 10th में, इट वॉज 10th में 1994. इट वॉज वेरी ब्राइट एंड क्लियर, बहुत ही ब्राइट एंड क्लियर. नो क्लाउड, नथिंग वॉज देयर. एंड फॉर द पास्ट फ्यू डेज आई हैड बीन प्लेजेंटली बिसीज्ड बाय द डिग्निटरीज एंड द वर्ल्ड लीडर्स. आई हैड बीन बिसीज्ड, बिसीज्ड मींस सराउंडेड बाय, उसके चारों तरफ काफी डिग्निटरीज, बिग ऑफिशियल्स एंड ऑल द वर्ल्ड लीडर्स, वर्ल्ड लीडर थे. एंड हु वर कमिंग टू पे देयर रेस्पेक्ट्स before the inauguration. Inauguration se pehle they wanted to give him respect and thank for becoming the president of South Africa. Wo president banne ke liye usko dhanyawad dena chahte the, apna samman vyakt karna chahte the, because after all a non-racial democratic government was established in South Africa. Matlab ek democratic government, the government elected by democratically, jo democracy ke hisab se jo government chuni gayi thi, that was being established in South Africa. Uska matlab wapas uski inauguration thi. And the inauguration would be the largest gathering ever international leader on South African soil. And on this beautiful soil, beautiful South African soil, this will be the largest gathering. Sabse jyada bheed hogi isme. And on the South African soil, South Africa zameen par. The ceremony took place in the lovely sandstone amphitheater formed by the Union Building in Pretoria. प्रिटोरिया की जो यूनियन बिल्डिंग है, यूनियन मीन सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट की जो बिल्डिंग थी. एंड इट वाज ए एम्पीथिएटर. एम्पीथिएटर का मतलब ओपन थिएटर, बिकॉज़ द लार्ज गैदरिंग वाज एक्सपेक्टेड, दैट्स व्हाई दिस पर्टिकुलर एम्पीथिएटर, दिस बिल्डिंग वाज चोजन. ये चूज की गई थी बिकॉज ऑफ द लार्ज गैदरिंग. एंड फॉर डेकेड्स दिस हैड बीन द सीट ऑफ द वाइट सुप्रीमेसी. एंड फॉर डेकेड्स, काफी दशकों से, डेकेड 10, वन डेकेड मीन्स इक्वल टू 10. एंड दिस हैड बीन द seat for the white supremacy. White supremacy means in the South Africa there was a white people domination. It means the governments of the white people only was established in that one. Isme keval usi ki government established. And now it was the site for rainbow gathering different colors. Lekin abhi it has become the rainbow gathering of different colors. Rainbow gathering means the different colorful people, they have come there and to pay their respect to Nelson Mandela becoming the president of South Africa. South Africa is the president. Different type of colors and the nations of the installation of South African first democratic non-racial government, because who their country dignitaries or the leaders has come and their national flags and all everything was erected, that's why it was looking like rainbow means seven colors and all different colors. It was non-racial government was established. Okay, non-racial government is established on the lovely autumn day. It was the autumn day. Why it is called a autumn day? There can be two questions. Autumn is what? When the old leaves fall and new leaves starts. This can be. But there are two reasons. Question: why 10th May is called a autumn day? Why 10th May is called a autumn day? Because South Africa, it falls in the southern hemisphere. Yes, southern hemisphere may have, and in that hemisphere, the autumn season starts from March till May. May tak wo chalta hai. That's why 10th May, 10th day is in the month of May. It is in the autumn season. One question, one way you can answer like that. There can be another answer also for this question. Why 10th May is called a autumn day? Because the old system of the government was unturned. Purana jo system tha, where the white domination was there, that was unturned, owned, and new non-racial democratic government was established in South Africa. That's why it was a very important day, and it can be also be called a autumn day in South Africa. Autumn day is ko kaha ja sakta hai. Students, you can answer in both the ways. Aap dono tarike se answer de sakte ho. You have to justify your answer. Okay. On the lovely autumn day, I was accompanied by my daughter Jenani, on the podium. Podium means that lectures time. He was accompanied, uske saath mein thi, on the podium. Mr. D. Clark was the first sworn as a second deputy president. There were two, he was president and there were two deputy presidents. Two vice president thi. Second, who was that Dr. D. Clark. Jo Dr. D. Clark thi, wo pehle deputy president bane. Or the second, and Tobacco McCarthy was shown as the first deputy president. Wo first deputy means both they were deputy president. Wo dono deputy president means vice president. And when it was my turn, jab uska turn aaya, it means the narrator or the, you can say, author Nelson Mandela. I pledge to obey and uphold the constitution, to devote myself to the well-being of the republic and its people. Maine shapath li to uphold, matlab sabse upar samajhna, the constitution and the people, logon ko, apne desh ko aur us constitution ko, samvidhan ko. I pledge to obey karna, uphold the constitution ko apne se upar rakhna, matlab uska samman karna, and to devote myself to the well-being of the republic and its people, in logon ki well-being ke liye, achhai ke liye kaam karte rehna, and to assembled guests and the watching world, I said. Ab usne, he started addressing the nation, apne nation ko address karne laga. And he said, today all of us do our presence here. Hum aaj yahan upasthit hue hain. Isliye confirm glory and hope to a newborn liberty. Confirm means to give a hope and a newborn liberty. Ek shandar liberty jo swatantrata mili hai, isko hum dene ke liye, apne deshvasiyon ko dene ke liye ikatthe hue hain. Out of the experience of an extraordinary human disaster. Actually, these two words he has used. Extraordinary human disaster and extraordinary human achievement. Extraordinary human disaster. What is that extraordinary human disaster? When there was a white domination in South Africa, all sort of exploitations and discrimination was done against the black people. They were deprived of their even basic freedoms. Jo unki basic freedom thi, wo bhi unko nahi mili thi. This is known as the extraordinary human disaster. ये इसको एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरी ह्यूमन डिजास्टर होता है. लास्टली टू लॉन्ग, और जो काफी दिन तक चला था, मस्ट बी बोर्न ए सोसाइटी ऑफ विच ऑल ह्यूमन विल बी प्राउड, बट नाउ देयर शुड बी ए सोसाइटी, ऐसा समाज होना चाहिए वेयर एवरीवन फील प्राउड ऑफ इट, जहां पर सर कोई उसे प्राउड महसूस करेगा. इट मीन्स देयर विल नॉट बी एनी डिस्क्रिमिनेशन ऑन द बेस ऑफ कास्ट, कलर और स्किन. कलर ऑफ स्किन के लिए, कास्ट के लिए, there will not be any discrimination. Kisi bhi tarah ka bhedbhav nahi hoga. We, and now it is a part of his speech. Ye uske speech ka part hai. Directly it is taken from that. We, who are outlaws not so long ago. Outlaws not considered as a citizen of the country. Jab ज्यादा दिन नहीं हुए थे जब हमें एक नागरिक भी नहीं समझा जाता था, हैव टू बीन गिवन द रेयर प्रिविलेज टू द, और आज हमें एक दुर्लभ रेयर विच कैन नॉट बी मतलब विच कैन नॉट बी अचीव बाय एवरीवन, हर किसी को नहीं मिलती थी, प्रिविलेज टू होस्ट द नेशंस ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, होस्ट बनने के लिए नेशंस ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, वर्ल्ड के जो लीडर्स हैं टू देम होस्ट बिकॉज दे आर द गेस्ट एंड वी आर द होस्ट, हम होस्ट हैं और वो गेस्ट हैं, वर्ल्ड ऑन अवर सॉइल, हमारी सॉइल पर। वी थैंक ऑल ऑफ आवर डिस्टिंग्विश्ड इंटरनेशनल गेस्ट, हम अपने सारे इंटरनेशनल गेस्ट को थैंक करते हैं फॉर हैविंग कम टू टेक पोजेशन विद द पीपल ऑफ आवर कंट्री ऑफ व्हाट इज आफ्टर ऑल द कॉमन विक्ट्री फॉर जस्टिस फॉर पीस और फॉर ह्यूमन डिग्निटी, जो ह्यूमन डिग्निटी की जो एक जीत हुई है, जस्टिस न्याय की, पीस शांति की, एंड दोज द लीडर हु हैव कम हियर, जो यहाँ पर आए, हम वी आर वेरी ऑब्लाइज्ड, वी आर वेरी थैंकफुल टू ऑल दोस, उन सबके हम बहुत ही आभारी हैं। वी विल कंटिन्यू नेक्स्ट ओके इन द नेक्स्ट पीरियड अप टू हियर इज ओके।